Arizona has not one, but two active volcanoes. Don't believe me? Just ask the native Hopi people who witnessed and then fled the unusually powerful explosive volcanic eruption near Flagstaff 940 years ago, as tales of this eruption still exist. Or you can see the first-hand results of that eruption for yourself by visiting Sunset Crater National Monument, which contains a landscape covered in young-looking ash deposits of up to 40, yes, 40 feet thick. These ash products erupted alongside a series of extensive lava flows which burned regional forests across a period of several months, with these basalt lava flows going on to cover an area of 4.95 square miles or 12.83 square kilometers. Most of these eruptive products originated from the cinder cone from which this national monument gets its name, the Sunset Crater Cinder Cone, which rises 1,115 feet above the surrounding landscape and measures 1.1 miles across. The Sunset Crater eruption was about one-fifth as explosive as the 1980 eruption of Mount St. Helens, emplacing 0.28 cubic kilometers of tephra with at least 4 inches or 10 centimeters thick of ash falling across an area of 268 square miles. Yet, if you look around, you can see that dozens, no hundreds, of similar features exist in close proximity, most of which are also cinder cones. Sunset Crater merely represents the youngest feature of a much broader volcanic field known as the San Francisco Volcanic Field. This still active, albeit currently quiet volcanic field contains almost everything a volcanologist could ask for, an originally 16,000-foot-tall stratovolcano which once had substantial glacial coverage, lava domes, cinder cones, more explosion craters, lava tubes, and even some obsidian-rich lava flows. In total, these more than 600 distinct vents have been in place across the last 6 million years, being spread across an area of just under 6,000 square kilometers. With the exception of 5 vents that erupted multiple times, every other vent is monogenetic, meaning it erupted once and then never erupted again, with Sunset Crater being one such example of a monogenetic vent. These vents generally get progressively older the further west you go, and younger the further east you go. While we aren't 100% sure why this volcanic field exists, this trend of younger volcanism moving opposite the direction of the North American plate suggests an origin of an underlying mantle hotspot which is likely 100 to 200 degrees Celsius hotter than the surrounding mantle. This causes more buoyant molten rock to rise and intrude into the crust, forming a cluster of volcanic vents. Most initial eruptions emplaced low viscosity basalt lava, which traveled fairly sizable distances and formed cinder cones. More explosion craters would form if substantial groundwater existed overlying a rising magmatic intrusion. However, if an unusually large batch of magma remained in the crust for an extended period of time, it could experience fractional crystallization, allowing for more viscous lava varieties to erupt multiple times and form a polygenetic center. This formed the andesite to dacite lava dome complex volcanoes of Bill Williams Mountain, Sitgreaves Mountain, Kendrick Peak, and O'Leary Peak, alongside the creation of a towering stratovolcano which for more than 100,000 years was likely the tallest point in what is today the lower 48 U.S. states. San Francisco Peak represented a towering stratovolcano which at one time was quite similar in appearance to California's modern Mount Shasta. It formed through hundreds of explosive eruptions which emplaced overlapping layers of andesite lava and ash, rising eventually to an elevation of 16,000 feet. However, probably due to a cryptodome forming on its eastern flank, a lateral blast ensued, causing large sections of the volcano to slide away, much like what happened at Mount St. Helens in 1980. This left behind a large east-northeast horseshoe-shaped scar, with the tallest remnant peak today being Humphreys Peak. Eruptions in recent times have solely occurred in the eastern one-third of the field, forming Merriam Crater 20,000 years ago, whose lava flows temporarily dammed the Little Colorado River, SP Crater with its highly scenic cinder cone and basaltic andesite lava flow in 3750 BCE, and Sunset Crater in the year 1085. While this volcanic field will certainly erupt again, its recent rate of eruptions seem to be on the order of about once every 4,700 years on average. Future eruptions could be mildly explosive or highly explosive, although the most likely future eruption type will form a basaltic or basaltic andesite cinder cone with an associated lava flow. Since ash emissions during any future eruption could disrupt regional air traffic, and the major city of Flagstaff is fairly close by, the U.S. Geological Survey designated the San Francisco volcanic field as a moderate threat volcano. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.